Well, folks, I'm going to take just a couple minutes. I know this isn't a how-to video, but I'm just going to show and explain real quick the optics we use and why we use them, a little bit about glassing that may help you in finding a giant bull elk or giant old muley. First, as far as optics, we use either Leica, Zeiss, or Swarovski optics. And we normally pack 10s around our neck. We actually are using the Geovid here that has the rangefinder, and actually the 15s have the rangefinder in them also. One of the great things and why you're using 15s is using a tripod. As far as tripods, this is the Swarovski's carbon tripod. It's just great. It's very light. We use Bogan a lot. Bogan's just an incredible tripod also. It's good to have some weight in your tripod. You don't want it too heavy, so you can hike good with it, but you need a little bit of weight when that wind comes up to give you great stability in the wind. And I like these quick releases. I use these Bogans. I think they're a star, six-sided, just so you can just quickly change out really fast what optics you're going to use. I mean, whether it's a spot and scope or your 15s. Also, with our new MossBack Bino hooker, which hooks in the back of your belt, keeps that weight, slipping off. These 15s click on just as easy, and these things are a must in some big, big open country also. One thing about using your optics I want to explain though, is that when you are looking either through with a spotting scope, is when you're just scanning with a spotting scope, just move your spotting scope, either get a rhythm side to side or up and down and stay in that rhythm. But move it and stop, and then watch everything around in the circle to make sure you're looking at everything. Look for a little antler tipping underneath a tree or a little shadow under a tree. But look in the entire circle before you move your scope onto the next area, and then look in that entire circle. One thing I have learned though is when you are glassing at prime time, in the mornings and evenings, you need to glass faster. And this is a key, because if you just go really super slow like this, you know, these deer are up moving. They're going from their bedding to feeding areas. You need to glass faster. And then during the late morning, start glassing slower and start looking under every rock and every tree for that little glint of an antler or just a buck bedded or a big old bull bedded. And this will definitely help you if you just slow down and look. Same way if you're using the 15s. Get them exactly set to your eye level. Move them a little bit. Just study that area right around the circle. This will greatly enhance what you are finding in the field. One other thing as far as spotting scopes that we get asked the most is also, besides the brand, is the angled or straight. We prefer angled. I think once you use angle, you'll all agree with us that it is by far the best. I hope these tips will help you to find more giant elk, more giant muleys, or whitetails, whatever your favorite game is.